Recorded.
Good morning, students. Today we are going to see about the checkpointing and rollback recovery. Before going to the checkpoint and rollback recovery, we have to see about the basic concepts of the rollback and checkpoints. Rollback is nothing but that we are going to restore the system back to the consistent state after a failure. Why we are doing this means, when we have a failure in a particular transaction, we have to restore the system to from some particular checkpoints. That checkpoint is nothing but the saved state of your transaction process. Okay, and then before we are going to see about the algorithms in the rollback recovery, we have to see about the domino effect. The domino effect is nothing but the dependencies may force some of the processes that did not fail to roll back. That means many processes in the system are not rollbacking to the particular checkpoints. That effect is known as the domino effect. This will create many processes will not go to the rollback. Means many transactions will be failure in the distributed system. Next, we are going to see about the three rollback algorithms: coordinated checkpoint algorithm rollback recovery, communication induced checkpointing rollback recovery, and then log based rollback recovery. Okay, in coordinated checkpoint rollback recovery, process coordinate their checkpoints to form a system consistent state. Okay, and then in communication induced, it will have the piggyback replication, and then log based, as usual, in the log based is nothing but it will have the saved rollback recovery. We will see all these three things in a detailed manner. Next, if you want to represent the checkpoint, we have to represent like this: C of I, comma K. The kth local checkpoint at the process PI. A process PI takes the checkpoint C of I 0 before it starts its execution. Before it starts execution, the checkpoint has to be enabled. These things are nothing but you have already known about the consistent state. Consistent state is nothing but it will have a constant transaction between the distributed system. Next, we will see about the different types of messages: in-transit message, lost message, delayed messages, orphan messages, and then duplicate messages. In-transit message is nothing but those messages have been sent but not yet received. That means the sender, we have the already sent the messages, but the receiver not received the message. Those messages nothing but a in-transit message. Lost message is nothing but messages whose send is done but receive is undone. The difference between the in-transit and lost is nothing but the in-transit may be received at the receiver, but the lost message may not be received at the receiver. Okay, and then delayed messages and then orphan messages. Delayed messages is nothing but the messages will be received at the receiver, but at the some delayed time. Orphan messages is nothing but the messages will be received at the receiver, but not known about the sender name or ID, anything. And then duplicate messages are nothing but it will the same messages will be received at the receiver many times. Okay, these are the different types of messages. Next, we are going to see about the uncoordinated checkpoint. Each process has autonomy in deciding when to take the checkpoint. Okay, each process has the log or anything. We have to decide when we have to make the checkpoints. We can't do the checkpoints in a granted manner. We have to make the checkpoints in a particular time. Okay, the advantage of this is lower runtime overhead due to normal execution. Since we have, if we have the many checkpoints, means it will lead to the many problems. Okay, disadvantage is nothing but domino effect during the recovery. If we reduce the checkpoints, means there will be a chance to occur a domino effect. And then recovery from failure is slow because process needs to be integrated with the final consistent set of checkpoints. And then it is not suitable for the frequent output commitments. Okay. Next, we are going to see about the three types: coordinated checkpoint. In the coordinated checkpoint, we are having the block checkpointing and non-blocking checkpointing. In the block checkpointing, after a process takes a local checkpoint to prevent orphan messages. Orphan messages is nothing but those receiving sender may not be known about the receiver. It remains blocked until the entire checkpointing activity. For example, if you are having a transaction, we are having a checkpoint, it prevents the orphan messages until the checkpoint will be crossed. The disadvantage of this method is the computation is blocked during the checkpoint because the orphan message may include into the transaction. Next one, the non-blocking checkpoint. The process need not stop their execution while taking the checkpoint. The fundamental problem in calling the checkpoint is to prevent the process from receiving application messages that would make the checkpoint inconsistent. It will prevent the many messages from the receiving application messages. So it will make the checkpoint inconsistent. It should not block or it should not stop the receiving messages. Next, we are going to see about the checkpoint, what are the problems occur in the coordinated checkpoint, or otherwise we can say about the disadvantages of the coordinated checkpointing. First one is the checkpoint inconsistency, and then second one is we can give a solution with the FIFO channels. In this diagram, we are having an initiator in the board. First we will see about this diagram A, okay? The process P0 and then process P1. We are having a checkpoint of C0 here, and then we are having a checkpoint of C1 here. The C0 is corresponds to the process P0, and then C1 is corresponds to the process P1, okay? We are sending a message from P0 to P1 here. After the checkpoint of C0, the message is sent, but before the checkpoint of P1, the message is received. This is called as an inconsistent state, okay? So to avoid the inconsistent state, we should make the checkpoint in the FIFO manner. That is nothing but the first in, first out. At first itself, you have to make the checkpoint. Here we are seeing that P0 corresponding checkpoint C0 and then P1 corresponding checkpoint C1. Okay? After that, the checkpoint, the message is received. Okay? If we make like this means, though we have lost the message, we can roll back to the particular checkpoint. But here you can't do. Okay, this is the disadvantage of the coordinated checkpoint. Next, we see about the communication induced checkpoint. There are two types of checkpoints, autonomous checkpoints and then forced checkpoints. Okay? Autonomous checkpoints is nothing but it will make the checkpoints automatically based on the transaction. But the forced checkpoints is nothing but the user or the software has to force the transaction to make the checkpoints at a particular moment. Communication induced checkpoint piggyback the protocol related information on each application. The receiver of each application uses the information to determine whether it has to force in advance or it has to make the autonomous. Okay, the forced checkpoint must be taken before the application process may process the contents of the message. Okay? In every algorithm, they are telling that we have to make the checkpoint before the sending or receiving of any messages. Okay? In contrast with the coordinated checkpoint, no special coordinated messages are exchanged. Okay? There are two types of induced checkpointing. This is two types of checkpoints here. Model-based checkpoints, index-based checkpoints. Based on the application, it may vary the we can use the model based or index based. Next, we are going to see about the log based recovery. From the name itself, we can understand that log is nothing but it will save the checkpoints. From the log, we can determine the checkpoints and then we can determine roll back to the particular question. Deterministic and then non deterministic events. Non deterministic events can be a receipt of message from another process or an event internal to the process. Each process we have the internal event. Non-deterministic events can be the messages from other process or the internal process events. Okay, a message sent event is not deterministic. So what are the messages for non-deterministic event? The messages from the other process and then internal process are said to be non-deterministic, and then message sent is nothing but the deterministic. Okay. The execution of the P0 is a sequence of 4 deterministic interval, sending and then receiving and then internal events like that. Okay. In the log-based rollback recovery assumes that all non-deterministic events can be identified and their corresponding determinants can be logged into a stable storage. We have to find first all non-deterministic events and we have to find the corresponding deterministic event and we have to log into a stable storage. Okay. During the main advantage of the log-based rollback recovery is nothing but during failure-free operation, each process logs the deterministic of all the non-deterministic events that it observes on the stable storage. Okay. It will have the non-deterministic or non-deterministic go in the failure system crash also. Next, we are going to see about the algorithm in the checkpointing algorithm. This is the first algorithm, code to a coordinated checkpointing algorithm. A coordinated checkpointing and recovery technique that takes a consistent set of checkpoint and avoids domino effect and live log problems during the recovery. The coordinated checkpoint is used on recovery techniques. It has the consistent set of checkpoint means the checkpoint will not vary. Consistent set means it will not vary and it will avoid the domino effect and live log problems. Live log problems is nothing but a deadlock problems. Okay? And then it includes the two parts. First one is the checkpointing algorithm. Second one is the recovery algorithm. And then here we are having the assumptions in each and every algorithm. Here we are using the FIFO channel, end-to-end protocols. In the communication failure, do not partition the network. These are the assumptions for before making the any algorithm. Okay? Here we are having the two checkpoints, permanent checkpoint and then tentative checkpoint. Permanent checkpoint is nothing but a local checkpoint. It will have a part of the consistent global checkpoint. Okay. Global checkpoint is nothing but a each and every distributed environment will have the local checkpoint. Permanent checkpoint, permanent checkpoint is nothing but the collection of various local checkpoint will be the part of the consistent global checkpoints. And then next we are having a tentative checkpoint. Temporary checkpoint becomes the permanent when the algorithm terminates successfully. Okay? When we are committing the particular transaction, the temporary checkpoint will be converted into a permanent checkpoint. Next, the two phases of the checkpoint algorithm. The first phase, the initiating process, takes a tentative checkpoint and requests all other processes to take the tentative checkpoints. Every process can send the messages after taking the tentative checkpoints. All the processes finally have the single same decision, do or discard. That means initiating process will have the tentative checkpoint, that all the processes will have the tentative checkpoints cannot send the messages. And when it will send the messages, it will send the message at the final commit statement. Whether it can send the message or it can discard the message. That means do is nothing but it will send receive the message. Discard is nothing but whether it will receive or discard the messages. And then second one is all process will receive the final decision from initiating process and act accordingly. Or based on the first process, based on the first event or messages, all process will receive the messages from the send events. And then the correctness of the algorithm is either all or none of the process take permanent checkpoints. Whether the permanent checkpoint can be taken by all of the process or none of the process. This indicates the atomicity property. Okay, either the transaction should be completed fully or the transaction should not be done. Okay, no process send message after taking the permanent checkpoint. Okay, before taking the permanent checkpoint itself, all the process should send the messages. And then next we are going to see about the rollback recovery algorithm. Here we are seeing only about the checkpoint algorithm. Already I have told that we are having a two phases in the checkpointing countdown coordinated checkpoint algorithm. First one is the checkpointing algorithm. Second one is the recovery algorithm. Till now, we have seen only about the checkpointing algorithm. Now, we are going to see about the recovery, rollback recovery algorithm. The rollback recovery is used to restore the system state to a consistent state after a failure with assumptions. Okay? If it is a single initiator, checkpoint and rollback recovery algorithms are not invoked concurrently. For example, if it is a single failure, means no need of the checkpointing rollback algorithms. If it is a multiple failures, we have to use this algorithm. Here we are having a two phases. The initiating process send a message to all other processes and ask preference. Okay. Why it is asking preference means all the processes no need to roll back from the starting itself. Only some of the processes need the rollback. So it asks the preference from the all the processes whether we have to reset from the previous checkpoints or not. All need to agree about either do or not. Okay. And then second one is the initiating process send the final decision to all the processes and act accordingly after receiving the final question. The both are same as in the checkpointing algorithm here. What we are saying, the same thing happened here also. Okay. First it will check whether all the processes have to send the messages to other processes, whether we have to restart from the previous checkpoint. And then second one is it will check the final decision. Okay. It is the example of the crowd-served coordinated checkpoint algorithm. Here we are having the X, Y and then Z. We are giving X1, we are having two checkpoints, and then here also two checkpoints, and then here also two checkpoints. If we have a failure here, we can roll back either from the checkpoint X1 and X2. Okay. Or otherwise, if we have a failure occur means while sending it, we can roll back from Y2 or Y1. Here also Z2 or Z1. Okay. Correctness of the algorithm is we have to assume from a